Welcome to Gayatri's Cook Spot. I'm Gayatri Kumar and today I'll show you how to make these buttery soft cinnamon rolls which are egg free too. So these are really soft in texture and tastes absolutely yum. If you haven't subscribed it to my channel, please subscribe, like, comment and share the video. To make these cinnamon rolls, it's really easy to make. But the final result makes a really good tea time treat. So first let's mix the dough. Before mixing the dough, you have to mix vinegar to 150 ml of milk to make buttermilk. You can also use buttermilk just like that. Take 150 ml of buttermilk and use. Okay, once you add vinegar to buttermilk, it's going to curdle and the consistency will become a little bit thicker. So set it aside for 5 minutes and then at that time you just mix all the dry ingredients together. Mix maida, 2 teaspoons of instant yeast. So I'm using instant yeast, so I'm just adding it directly to maida. But if you have dry yeast, the tiny pearl like one, you have to prove it and then add it. Okay, just add sugar and salt. These are the dry ingredients we are going to add for cinnamon rolls. Just mix everything properly. So you can either use a stand mixer or you can just use a wooden spatula and mix them properly. Before 2 or 3 weeks, I just posted a stand mixer review. If you haven't yet seen that video, please check it out. I'm just leaving the link here and in the description box below. Now add buttermilk. So buttermilk is the only liquid ingredient we're going to add, and actually we'll be adding butter also. But if you are adding, you can also make buttermilk out of curd, like by mixing 50% of curd and 50% of water, or you can just use store-bought buttermilk. Anyhow, you need 150 ml of buttermilk. Okay, once the buttermilk is totally incorporated into the dry mixture, let us add butter. So make sure that all the dry ingredients what you're using for the recipe are at room temperature, because when you make bread dough, if any ingredient is cold or anything, then the proving time will take a lot more. Okay, so make sure that your buttermilk, everything is at room temperature. And now just mix everything together until the dough comes together. Okay, so at first it may seem a little bit drier, but the butter, when it melts, it will become really nice and it will incorporate fully into the flour. But if you still feel the dough is dry, just add 1 or 2 teaspoons of milk extra. Okay, so for hand kneading you might need 10 minutes of kneading, but for a stand mixer you just need 7 minutes of kneading. So after 7 to 10 minutes of kneading, just remove the dough out of the stand mixer. We are actually going to use the same bowl for proving also. Okay, so we're just removing it from the stand mixer and we are going to prove it until the dough rises double in volume. Okay, so usually bread dough, it takes nearly 45 minutes to 1.5 or 2 hours to double in volume. Like, it's based on the temperature, the climate of your place. Okay, if you live in a hot place, it may take just 45 minutes to double in volume, and if you live in a really cold place, it's going to take 2 hours or even 3 hours. So just check for the double volume of the dough, not the time. Okay, add a little bit of oil on top of the dough. This is to prevent the dough from drying out and forming a skin. Okay, just apply it evenly on the sides of the bowl as well. Okay, and now let's cover the bowl with a cling film and let it sit on the counter at room temperature until it doubles in volume. And if you also if you want to do the cinnamon rolls the next day, you can also refrigerate the dough at this point. Okay, so after proving, after your dough is double in size, we can move on to the next step, that is mixing the filling. Okay, to brown sugar, add cinnamon. So the amount of cinnamon you're going to add will depend upon how you like cinnamon flavor. If you are a really great fan of cinnamon flavor, you can add 1.5 to 2 tablespoons. But if you're not a very great fan of cinnamon, just add 1 teaspoon. That's it. Okay. So just mix together brown sugar and cinnamon, and this is the filling we're going to use. Okay. So you can see that my dough is double in volume. At the same time, I'm also preheating my oven to 200 degrees centigrade. So when your cinnamon rolls are ready to be baked, your oven will also be ready. Okay. So now my dough has brewed properly. I'm just taking the dough out of the bowl, transferring it onto my table to shape it. Okay. Just press it well, and we're going to roll it out into a rectangle. Okay. So make sure that the length of the rectangle is at least 12 inches, okay, 12 inches or a little bit more, and the width can be anywhere from 9 to 10 inches, okay. So make sure that it's evenly thick, not that one area is thicker and the other area is thinner. You shouldn't roll like that. You should make it even all over, okay. So once you shape it into a rectangle, we will just add the filling what we have made, the brown sugar filling. You can add it directly onto the dough. You can also add some butter also here, like you can apply 2 or 3 tablespoons of butter and then add the brown sugar filling. Anyway, you can add. If you want it more buttery, go for a butter layer, otherwise just stop it with just brown sugar filling, okay. Now just apply it evenly on your rectangle, and we're going to roll the dough into a tight log, okay. You sometimes they also add butter along with the cinnamon and brown sugar and make it into a paste and then apply it on the dough. So there are so many ways you can make the filling, so it's up to you. Like if you like so much of butter, you can go for that. So for me, as the dough itself has a lot of butter, I didn't actually add butter here, okay. And start rolling from the longest edge of your rectangle, okay. So make it tight, don't make it into a loose log, just try to make it into a tight log, okay. It will be slightly tough at this beginning to roll it, but once you roll twice or thrice, then it will become easier. So after you roll, you have to pinch the edge of the rectangle so that you seal the log, okay. We don't want it to unravel when you actually shape it. So just tightly pinch the side and the log together so that it sticks together properly, okay. Now you have to divide this log into 12 equal portions, and you also need a tray, deep tray, that is 9 inches by 13 inches. That's also a rectangle, okay. So just slice the log into 12 equal portions. You can also measure the log and then calculate the exact thickness you want, and then you can just divide it. So if you want to do if you want to need exact thickness in all the rolls, you can go for that. Otherwise you can just do it like how I'm doing, okay. So after it's divided into 12 equal portions, just slice it off, slice the rolls. Use a sharp knife, it will be easier. So I used a bread knife and it was really tough for me to slice the rolls actually. So go for a sharp knife and then cut it with a single cut. So once you have sliced all the rolls, you can just arrange them on the 9 by 13 inches rectangular deep pan. Okay, just keep them ready. You just apply some butter on it and then keep the pan ready before you slice the rolls. So now the rolls are sliced. I'll bring out the pan now. Actually, when you arrange the rolls in the pan, they are not going to fill the pan, okay. There will be a lot of distance between the rolls, but as we have added yeast, the dough is going to prove, and it's going to double in volume, and all the gaps will be filled out while proving. Okay, so don't worry about the gaps between the rolls now, and also the smaller ones, smaller rolls, just try to keep them between the bigger ones. Okay, so now I have arranged all the 12 inside my 9 by 13 inches pan, and again there is a lot of space between them. Just cover the rolls with a cling film and let us prove it for the second time. The second proof will be a lot lesser than the first proving. Okay, so if your first proof took 45 minutes, the second proof is going to take only 20 minutes. And the first proof took nearly 1 hour or 2 hours, then your second proof is going to take either 25 minutes or 40 minutes. Okay, just until the spirals touch each other, but still there is gap between them. Okay, so this is where you have to stop the second proving, and then apply some milk on top of the rolls. So milk wash is actually important in eggless bread, because you know, usually in bread that use egg, they apply egg wash to get the nice caramelized color on top. But as we don't use eggs, we will be using milk for milk, that egg wash instead of egg wash. And sometimes you can also add some sugar or honey to the milk to get more color on top. Okay, so once you apply milk evenly on the rolls, it's time to bake the rolls. So bake the rolls for 20 to 25 minutes in the preheated oven. And by the end of that time, like 20 to 25 minutes, let us make the glaze. Okay, to icing sugar, you need to add melted butter and vanilla, either extract or essence. So I haven't sifted the icing sugar. You can see that it's totally full of lumps, but it's okay. It's going to dissolve completely when you add milk. And be careful while adding milk, because we don't want a runny glaze. Okay. Just add tablespoons of milk until everything comes together, and be very careful while adding milk. Okay, just add tablespoon by tablespoon, and then keep on mixing the icing sugar glaze until the consistency required is got. Okay, just if you add everything in a go, it's going to be very thin, and it won't be that good on cinnamon rolls. Okay, so you can see that all the lumps are clear now. The mixture is nice and smooth, and the glaze will be very shiny because it's just sugar. It's just spreadable consistency, not even dropping consistency, it's just spreadable consistency. So now take the rolls out of the oven. You can see that it has completely filled your tray and it looks really good. Now just add the glaze on top. You can just drizzle it, you can just apply blobs of the glaze and then spread it with a spatula. You can do however you want. Okay, so the glaze adds a nice crunch to the soft cinnamon roll. So this glaze will actually set into a crisp topping. So just allow it to cool a bit and you get a nice crisp topping. Okay, just apply it evenly on top. So if you are a sugary person, you can even add 2 cups of icing sugar for the glaze, but if you don't want that much sweet, just top with 1 cup. So once I have applied everything, that's it, my cinnamon rolls are done. You can actually serve it immediately, just hot out of the tray, or you can just let it sit for a little bit until it cools down a bit, and then you can serve it. So however you serve, it's going to taste so delicious. And you can see that it's really soft. Look at the texture of the bun, it's very soft. That too, when you serve it when it's hot, it's going to be very soft, ultra soft. Okay, so I hope you like this video. So if you are trying it at home, please let me know in the comments whether you like the buns or not. Just I'll show you how it looks inside, all the cinnamon sugar, the butter and the glaze, everything together with that bread, it's going to taste divine. Okay, so please let me know if you like the taste of the cinnamon rolls, and just let me know in the comments. And please give a thumbs up for my video and then share it with your friends. Okay, see, after a while, if you touch the glaze, it doesn't feel sticky at all. It will set nice and properly. Okay, and I'm really happy that I shared this video with you. Please like it, please share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and thank you so much for watching. Bye.